the sand out of your ears and listen up.
All of you who've given up on the clevis and been taking it easy are gonna have a little change of heart. You got that?
Ah, just awoke.
What are you doing?
Nothing, Nutch. Just gilling my sputs for haul to ear. Dutter do youing, wum-ass.
Hope, can you interpret this for me?
It seems to me like it's some kind of code or cipher, but I don't have enough data yet to break it.
Can't you speak normally?
Show nit. Of course I can. Look, I don't have any info about any treasure, if that's what you're looking for. I've got no interest in it. Boofad to you.
Doesn't seem like many people choose to live out here unless they're after treasure. So, what's your story?
Meath be Lee. The world's going to end soon anyway, right? If that's the case, what's the point in having dreams or working hard?
So, sitting around waiting for the end was the best idea you could come up with. Nice way to spend your last days.
Well, yeah, it's boring, but nothing I do now makes any sort of difference anyway, so why bother? No matter how much I might unravel mysteries of the past, none of these bandits care. They don't even listen to my findings. Tro wouldn't even nice to Unsterdand.
I get that it's hard to stay motivated when no one appreciates what you do.
I'd say so. If you get it, why are you giving me a hard time? Just leave me alone. I'm done with all of it. I ditched all my equipment in the desert. If you find any of my old things, they're yours. Take them away with you.
I think I may just do that. They deserve better than getting tossed aside by some sulking, spoiled kid.
Take them, Ten.
It's a big desert, you know. Do you really expect to find these things out there in the middle of nowhere?
I'd better be able to, after running my mouth like that.
Before you head out, it may be a good idea to talk the expedition through, to make sure we're on the same page. So what you're looking for is the Holy Clavis, a mystical relic said to gather the souls of the dead and believed to lie in this desert. Both Monoculus, the gang of bandits headed by Fang, and the seculars of the Order have tried in vain to find the treasure.
But despite their best efforts, no one has even gotten closer.
Yes, but Light, you're forgetting one crucial thing. You managed to get the Crux to react to you because you're the savior. I'm sure you'll be able to break the seal that protects the Clavis.
Maybe. But if you want the truth, I'm more curious about Fang. She used to be with the Order, and now look at her. She's head of a bandit gang? Isn't this the kind of magnifying glass that appraisers use? It looks like it's pretty worn.
It does look rather old, but it seems like it's been taken good care of. Maybe this is the instrument that Elmer was talking about. The next time you stop by the bandit settlement, you should show him what you found.
What is it? Don't tell me you actually found something.
Is this it? What you threw away?
How did you... Dad's loop.
Dad?
Never mind that. Just give it back to me. Now!
You want it back? Who was it that told me I was welcome to whatever I could find? I'm not sure I want to give it up.
Fine. I'll talk if I have to. My dad was a great bandit, okay? But he was also a great appraiser. He spent his whole life studying the relics in these ruins.
So he wanted you to follow in his footsteps?
No, it wasn't like that. Not at all. He taught me everything he knew so that I could become a scholar. He wanted me to be able to unravel the mysteries of the past. But then he disappeared. never made it home. No one ever found any clue as to what happened. He left me and took my only chance at becoming a scholar with him. Didn't have much choice. I could appraise or starve.
Is that why you threw away his tools? In order to spite your father?
It was stupid. I was stupid. I should have just done what my dad wanted and kept working to be a real scholar. But he's gone, and it's too late now. This world is nearly done for. But if I'm ever reborn, I promise I'll take things a bit more seriously. I'll give it my all. I'll study hard, and I'll become a great scholar and solve all kinds of mysteries. Or maybe that's too much to ask for.
You should dream big, and the first step to making your dream come true is believing it can come true. Are you seeing this, Hope? It must be the Heretic Sanctuary.
Hopefully we'll be able to find out.
Maybe you can help me. I'm looking for something called Starlit Spice. Do you know it?
Starlit Spice, you say? It's also a very rare item. I have none in stock, but bring me the ingredients and I'll brew up a batch in a jiffy.
Sounds good to me.
Take a look at the recipe.
Huh. Looks like I already have all the...
Bring me the ingredients list.
I've got everything you wanted to make a batch of that potion.
So I see. Now if you'll just give old Rubrio a minute here. There we go. No need for payment. Before you go, there's something you should know about that potion.
Does it have side effects?
No, it's nothing dangerous like that. The scent of the antidote has a certain, shall we say, power over the feline species. Take every precaution and avoid all cats while this is in your possession.
Great. Nothing dangerous at all then.
Yes. It drives them into quite a murderous frenzy.
My gut says that's Ronin.
You don't miss... Damn, these cats are fast. Oh well. Come on, Light. Back to Rubrio we go with the ingredients.
Thank you.
this? Come again.
Train bound for the wild lands and the
Today, the City of Light. A great number of our... Let us offer prayers...
Look at that!
not hope to win.
The strangest beast slurp.
opponent. I challenge you.
You killed it? But how? How did you defeat that thing alone?
Well, it wasn't an easy battle.
You don't have to tell me twice. It belonged to the fallen men. Because of your actions, they're resting peacefully. What a coward I am. In my mind, the beast had become chaos itself. But then you dispatched it alone. How powerful could it have been, really, to be slain by just one man? Damn it, you inspire me!
Not to be reckless, I hope.
Never. Caution is my middle name, after all. But we bounty hunters, we like to live on the edge. Danger. That's what it's all about. Can't live without it, like you can't live without air.
Bring me the ingredients list. Snatched by cat.
Something important. This Savior has to return to the Ark once a day. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. You have to present your Aradia to God to slow down the destruction of the world. No matter where you are, no matter what you're doing, you'll be transported up here to the Ark at 6 a.m. sharp. Don't forget that, okay?
This is bad!
I don't like this.
Something I think you should know. Something important. The Savior has to return to the Ark once a day. No ifs, ands, or buts. What's about it? You have to present your Aradia to God to slow down the destruction of the world. No matter where you are, no matter what you're doing, you'll be transported up here to the Ark at 6 a.m. sharp. Don't forget that, okay?
There's something I think you should know. Something important. The Savior has to return to the Ark once a day. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. You have to present your Aradia to God to slow down the destruction of the world. No matter where you are, no matter what you're doing, you'll be transported up here to the Ark at 6 a.m. sharp. Don't forget that, okay?
What are you doing now? This is bad!
Enemies?
time to wake up. Ronan?
My name is Ronan. Am I in my own body again?
Yep. Looks like this stuff actually worked. Welcome back to your old life.
Back? But if I'm here, then where's Jem?
Look, she's gone. You know that. She's been gone for decades. I know it's a hard reality to face, but you can't keep running from it anymore.
I know. She's never coming back. I get it. You're right. I have to face the truth. But I miss her. I'd give my own life to bring her back.
But that's not what I want.
Who is that? Is that you, Jem?
It is, and I'm here to tell you I want you to live, Master. If you die, there will be no one left in the world who remembers me. I lived a short but perfect life. You treated me with love. I couldn't have asked for anything more. I'll always be with you in your heart and in your memories. I want you to be happy, just like you were when we were together.
Jem. Did you see that? I actually talked to Jem. It's like a dream come true.
You experienced something very special. A miracle, even.
I owe all of this to you and Lumina. Thank you, from the bottom of my heart.
You're thanking Lumina? Have you forgotten she's the reason you almost spent eternity as a cat?
I'm not so sure about that. I think she knew that I'd go to great lengths to bring Jem back, even if it meant hurting myself in the process. I think Lumina saved me from myself.
If that's what you choose to believe, I won't stop you. The important thing to remember is that Jem will always be with you in your heart, and that's where she'll stay.
Welcome back, Light. Now step forward and offer your Aradia so we can give time back to the world. Pray.
As the world dies around me, I offer this blessing. Is this fruit from the light?
With the power of Aradia, you have successfully extended the world's life. Come here and I'll explain. This is Yggdrasil, the Tree of Life. It's a holy tree and its life force is entwined with that of the world. Aradia gives Yggdrasil the power to grow. As the tree grows stronger, so too does the world. With enough Aradia, you can extend its life and push back the Day of Destruction. Up to 13 days, after which God awakens.
So the more Aradia I can collect, the bigger that tree will grow. And the bigger the tree, the longer the world has before Doomsday.
There are certain areas within Nova Chrysalia that I want you to focus on. 5 locations where I'm picking up anomalous chaos readings.
And I'm guessing one of those locations is right where Snow is.
Yes, exactly. The palace in the city of Usnan. There is another spot, in the heart of Luxarian, the holy city. One more in the scorching sands of the Dead Dunes. And finally, I've measured large chaos fluctuations at 2 locations in the Wildlands.
4 regions, 5 locations.
To be more precise, the goals are people, not places. For example, the chaos activity in and around Snow's palace is linked to him, and the darkness in his heart. It's the same kind of chaos that I'm picking up in the other 4 locations.
And you want me to find these 5 people?
They're your priority. Yes. Those people have massive burdens on them. The fate of many rests on their shoulders, and that makes your task all the harder. Helping them will not be easy, even for God's handpicked savior. But I can help you. There's a hard truth we must face. There are thousands of people down in the world waiting to be saved, but you cannot help all of them. It's not possible.
I've only got a handful of days. There just isn't enough time, right?
This will sound cold, but you need to be efficient. Saving people who are suffering under the heaviest burdens will give you more Aradia, which is good for us. But the greater the burden, the more you might have to do before that soul can be saved. Sometimes, solving someone's problem might just take too long.
You're saying I shouldn't waste time on helping the hard cases. I've got to pick and choose who gets saved.
Of course it would be best if you could save everyone, but you can't. It's a numbers game, Light. The more souls you save, the more Aradia you can gather and offer to the tree. The time spent helping one person might be better spent saving the souls of 10 others.
Efficiency by volume, is that it? A numbers game, like you say. Control costs and maximize profits. What is it that they say? Time is money.
In this world, all the clocks count to 12, but that wasn't always the case. Back in the old days, all clocks went to 13. Somehow, when the chaos first flooded into the world, we lost that 13th hour. It was one of the great mysteries. No one could figure it out. But happen, it did. And the results were dramatic. Space-time has been damaged. Where once each day lasted 26 hours, now only lasts 24. 2 hours of every day gone, just like that. The lost time.